Hey everyone, welcome to Still Moments with Jesus, and I'm your host, Brian Semilopati. Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, from wherever you are around the globe listening in to us. This is such a joy, and it's such a privilege to have you. We have had such a blast just creating the content that we are sharing this week with regards to Christian asceticism or mysticism. That's deeply tied into the monastic movement, whether Eastern Christian monasticism or Western Christian monasticism. And we felt that the content we've shared this week should be substantial enough to help give you an idea of spiritual practices that you could engage in if you did not know about these practices before, right? Or if you had known about them, now you understand what the impetus, what the drive is to participate in them or and dig into them a little further, right? On your end, regardless of wherever you come from and whether you're a new Christian, old Christian, unbeliever, and just someone who's just inquisitive about the Christian faith. We tend to think also here, some moments with Jesus, that immersing yourself in these experiences is what makes the difference when it comes to knowing Christ and knowing him fully and truly. And it goes just beyond just reading the text and learning the text and reading the text and being able to be familiar with every single Bible chapter and verse. But this actually goes to how we practice and integrate all that we've learned from the text into our daily lives. And so today I want to round off by discussing in brief one quick thing. And it's something that comes from a part that we do not talk about as much in many Christian traditions, but is still something of value. You have probably heard this said as you read the Psalms, as you read the book of Joshua, or if you've read the beginning of the book of Revelation of St. John. And it goes something like this. I will meditate or read aloud your word or your law or your commands and meditate on them day and night. Now, that those set of words will appear in different ways, in different fashions, in these various contexts that I've just shared, whether it be the book of Joshua, the Psalms, or the first chapter of the book of Revelation. And there's a blessing attached to this idea, and it is the root sense of where we get the thought concept of meditating within the Christian tradition. If any one of you have probably watched Morgan Freeman's concept of God, his whole docuseries, he does highlight something that he didn't know or didn't fully understand at the time, was that within the Judeo-Christian landscape, including the Islamic tradition, it is assumed you're talking to God as a person, like someone who is there, someone with you. You don't have to conjure up this God. You don't have to perform rituals to summon up this God. This God is there. And this is the knowledge I want you to have as you consider and contemplate over the concept of meditation. For it is a practice that was taken very seriously by Christian mystics and ascetics of old. And they felt that not only do we learn something new about ourselves in the practice, but that we have something more to give to the world by spending time meditating on the scriptures. This is what Joshua promised Moses he was going to do when he said, as for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord and we will meditate on the word day and night. Same thing David says, and the book of Revelation tells us that blessed is the one who reads aloud or meditates, for that matter, on this word. And this is something I hope you get to do on your own, by yourself, and try in those moments to focus in on the words or the scripture or the verses that stand out to you and speak something to you in those moments. as you read aloud the scriptures, as you read aloud God's word, and ask yourself, why is it that this speaks to me the way it does? And watch your life change in ways you never thought or expected or imagined. So thank you so much for joining Still Moments with Jesus. And thank you so much for being with us as we now round off this series on Christian asceticism and mysticism. And I hope that you will be able to come back to us and give us feedback if you'd like us to continue with this someday. So thank you, thank you, thank you, and have a wonderful and blessed time. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.